talk about the Inquire tab that's available to you in Excel. I'm going to first show you what it can do, and then I'm going to show you how to put it onto your sheet. So the Inquire tab is particularly good if you have big data sheets that they're linked all over type of thing. So the first thing, when you go to the Inquire tab, you look and you have a number of things. You have a workbook analysis, workbook relationships, worksheet relationships. And so let's go through a few of these things. So let's go through workbook analysis report. Now, it shows you the link workbooks, and there's none of them, but you keep going down this, and it shows you there's 8,344 formulas in this sheet, and it goes down and it shows you numerical constants, and it basically breaks down the whole thing. You can visible sheets, textual with constants, there you go. And so you can basically see everything. Now, when you want it to have a more detailed report, you can export this report to an Excel sheet. So let's just go on to a few of the other options that you have. You can go and get workbook relationships. Now, this one isn't related to anything, but I was just going to show you how it looks. And so now we'll go to a worksheet relationship diagram. Now there's 8 sheets on this, and it's basically showing you that there's a few things linked, but it's kind of nice to see the sheet 1 and sheet 6 are related, and it shows you the constants that are between these. Now compare files. I don't have another file open, but you can compare 2 similar files, and it graphically shows you what's the same. You can clear excess cell formatting. Basically, it's a very helpful little thing. So how you go about adding this into your workbook, it's for 2013 and on. So you right click on the formula bar and you go to customize ribbon. And then on the left hand side, you click add-ins. And of course I have it added in already, but if you scroll down here, it's in the Inquire add-in. And so it's up here now. It was down here. It was under the inactive before I did it. So I selected it. And then the trick is that you have to, it's a .com add-in. So then you have to select this and then go .com add-ins, and then you go. And then it asks you again if you want to install it. And then once you select to install it, it will add it to your ribbon, and there you have it. Has all these useful features that you can use. Please subscribe.